is coming round. Do excuse the roughhousing, Asher. This pursuit of ours really can brutalize a man. Well, you've been a hard one to pin down. Your grandfather hasn't exactly made catching up with you easy, but some things prove to be inevitable. So here we are, a well overdue face to face. My name is Howard Whitman. Your grandfather, John Newman, and I were colleagues, brought together by our ambitions. John and I were put in charge of the most groundbreaking technological development in human history. It's no surprise we lost our minds. And your grandfather lost his way. Anyhow, it's quite the mess you've made. Time is anything but supple, but you've managed to bend, if not nearly break it. I bet it was quite the shock seeing all this, the payoff for your escapades. Look out that window. You think this world you've helped shape deserves to exist? A perpetual night, air as corrosive as rust, humanity shackled to these spiritless cocoons. Tell me, the world you left behind, would you trade those ruins for this? I did try to help you change course, but time is a complicated business. Didn't help that your grandfather led you astray, and that your seeing eye dog was blinder than its owner.
Was that a reference to me, you scoundrel?
Sounds like it's in need of an oil, too.
Whitman, you old brute, you've always undervalued.
Hush, the pair of you! We've got a planet to save. Or rather, you do, Asher. That machine, do you know what it does? Or has your grandfather kept you in the dark about that, too? You'd be well aware by now that time is stubborn, but with enough pressure in the right places, its course can be swayed. When this alteration occurs, a residual energy is created. This energy can tear holes in the very fabric of time and space. You know of what I speak. Luckily, you found yourself in the possession of a few of these. They allow one to seal such holes in time and, shall we say, steady the ship. The energy you've now collected will prove priceless for your new task, Asher. That fob watch of yours locked you into another's experience. With your set of vials and that machine, you can become time's master. Loose the shackles of another's body. A free agent. I leave you now with a choice. See out your days in this poisoned world. Or use this last vial and venture back to change the course of history once more. I'd love to join you, but like this world, I'm dying. I cannot influence the past in the same way you can. Time, quite literally, wastes me. Godspeed, Asher.
Asher? Asher, wake up! Oh, you're with us. I was worried there for a moment. That was one hell of a skirmish. This Whitman fella, I mean, he has a point, but also a rather funny way of showing it. I put my mind to it, but answers to this mess seem as scant as soda pop in a desert. Intriguing. This contraption is some kind of encoding machine. Might be linked to them vials. That lit her up like an Easter mass. We've got our work cut out for us here. It's gonna require you to get your hands dirty with what looks like, some programming. You'll need to handle this one yourself. My clockwork isn't proficient in these manners. Is a sight. Wondrous. The very essence of a singularity, distilled and reprogrammed. Try putting it back in that main chamber. I did have a passing rumination that the question is not whether to trust that chap, or even your grandfather for that matter, but rather our own eyes. That window, this portal to misery, surely supplies us honest counsel. He handed us this missing vial, and with it, the destiny of mankind. At least that was his sales patter. I'll take your lead on this, son. I'll be at your wrist, whatever way you turn. Been refined. We've got everything we need, bar an excuse to dally, Asher. Well, that's one proverbial chapter done. But if we want to finish our so-called book, we need 5 full vials to get this thing fully ticking. Wow, surely is something. A singularity.